and gentlemen, we are live on VA.boxing.tv, on Facebook and Twitter via the usual hashtags, etc. with the Sorlins in Germany, and also Only Full Fights via Facebook. Commentator Luke Madeira and John Evans. The officials have been appointed by the Central Area Council of the British Boxing Board of Control. Steward in charge at ringside, Mr. Kurt Haslam. This first contest is for 3 minute rounds of boxing in the super middleweight division. Introducing to you firstly, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the green colour short trim with red. At the weighing, he scaled 11 stone, 8 pounds, 4 ounces. A double centurion in our midst, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight is his 206th professional appearance. A warm welcome, please, for Starbridge's Kevin McCauley. And opposing him, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the black shorts trimmed with silver. At the weighing, he scaled 11 stone, 4 ounces. Tonight, he makes his proud professional debut. Presenting from Ruthin, here is Sean Yaxley. Timekeeper bell is Mr. Peter Humphrey. And the referee in charge of the action is Mr. Jamie Kirkpatrick. There's a slight lull before the start, ladies and gentlemen, but we can get underway for 3 minute rounds.
Okay, lads, you both know the rules. Keep the punch, watch your heads in close, obey my commands at all times, defend yourselves at all times. Touch gloves, good luck to you both.
Here we go then, the opening bout of the evening. Big night for Sean Yaxley, this. And John, we see a lot of guys making a debut. What's the most important thing to do in the opening round, the opening minute of the debut?
I think just got to feel the way in, don't they? You know, don't get too carried away. Don't get too carried away
second
by the crowd. Luckily,
one.
Sean's boxing away from home, so a bit of that pressure will be taken off him. But he's boxed all around the world, Sean. A very good amateur. Won the Welsh amateur national title twice as well. Boxed for Wales internationally. So really, he's been there and done it. It shouldn't really be too much new to him.
Yeah, that's a massive thing, making your debut as well, isn't it? Like you said, he's been there and done that. And already, he looks nice and relaxed in there. We see a lot of guys making the debut go hunting with that right hand early on and looking for that big shot, but he's nice and composed behind that jab.
Yeah, it's there, isn't it? You can see with Sean, nice and composed, just not forgetting to throw feints early on. Yeah, looks very good so far. McCauley just looks a little bit wary, doesn't he? Just gauging up what this newcomer's got for him.
Yeah, and already he's gone into his shell a little bit, and I think it's from those feints you just mentioned then. He's very wary of what Sean's throwing, even though he's not throwing much early on.
Sean will be used to drawing leads and counter-punching more. He's been a high-level amateur. Maybe for pausing, he's just trying to get Kevin to lead off so that he can counter.
Yeah, and a lot of guys find it so difficult to get their opponents throwing back early on in their career. And it's something he's going to have to deal with in his first few fights. He's going to have to try and work openings when his opponent's got his back to the ropes. He's tucking up, trying to catch everything on his gloves and not throwing back. High straight jab to the body. Yep.
Don't forget, all night you can get in contact using a hashtag VIP Boxing Live or comment on the Facebook stream. Generally read everything you're sending out.
Yeah, and there's some behind the scenes clips on Instagram as well. VIP Boxing on Instagram. Some videos and pictures throughout the night to see what goes on in the changing rooms.
Looks a bit rough, Kevin, today, don't you? Sorry, Kevin, if you're watching this. I know he's partial to a bit of a night out, Kevin. Hopefully he didn't have one last night.
I think he might be regretting it if he did. Wouldn't be top of my list to do the hangover.
One of my favourite journeymen, Kevin. You know, like we say, at some point he will bite down and we'll have a go on him and just see what Yaxley's got.
Yeah, and he's perfect for this stage of someone's career, isn't he? Because he will find you out, like we said earlier. There's a little cameo from him. Beautiful work from Yaxley, though. And I think that's the amateur pedigree stepping in there. He just took a step back after landing that body shot. Didn't get carried away with it.
As you said in the intro there, Luke, you know, it's Chris Sanigar in his corner. Someone who's been there, seen it and done it. Runs a hard school down there, doesn't he? You know, Yaxley will be fully prepared for this.
Yeah, 100%. You can see that in the, you can see this, his conditioning as well. Nice work behind that jab. first round in the bag, and we just started to see glimpses there of what Sean can do.
Yeah, I think he was due to make his debut in Newport a couple of weeks ago, so it's not too much of a delay, but it seems to be quite a few young professionals nowadays have to cope with a couple of stop starts, don't they, at the start of their career. But that's a first round safely under his belt.
And you can see him in the corner there, not sure what Chris was saying to him, but he was just saying, yeah, I won that round though. So still Chris seems to think it's improvements that can be made. Looks nice and relaxed in that corner though, as does Kevin.
Round two, Olympia filling up tonight. Seconds. Whenever you get a good local fight, it always draws a good crowd. And Tom McGuinness and Colin Day, bit of a local derby, two seconds still ambitious young fighters. Two. I think we'll have a good atmosphere later on.
Yeah, and I think we'll see a lot of the crowd sticking around as well from these early fights as well. We saw it at the Victoria Warehouse when Liam Taylor and Tyrone Nurse fought. Everyone stuck around for that main event. And it'll be similar tonight in Liverpool.
Yeah, again, just trying to draw a lead, actually. Just pawing, feinting, touching with a jab, just trying to get some kind of reaction from Kevin, isn't he?
Yeah, and we mentioned it earlier, he's going to have to deal with this as he has his first few fights as a professional. Because more often than not, the lead's not going to come back. He showed lovely patience so far, though. Picking his shot nicely with that jab. Right up to the body landing, and that's something that Chris was talking about in the corner after the end of the first. Just trying to work that body when McCauley's got his back to the ropes.
Yeah, just forced that opening, didn't he? Just by not throwing, and Kevin went back into the corner, put his hands up, and Sean was switched on enough to see the gap.
Yeah, and I think the best thing watching this so far is he's really thinking about his work in there. He's not throwing any shots for the sake of it.
Welsh boxing's always looking for next star, isn't it? You know, he's had a few interview with Barry Jones in Boxing Monthly, talking about the various world champions that have come from Wales. But it's always the next one coming through. You know, I know Andrew Selby seems to be making a bit of a comeback now. He's probably the next off the production line, I suppose, the next biggest star, but there's always a gap there for somebody else to come and get those big shows back to Wales.
Yeah, and there's a big boxing crowd there as well, and if someone can capture the imagination, they certainly will sell tickets and a lot of people will come and see them.
McCauley just inviting you, actually, and he didn't quite fall for it.
Must be so frustrating when you land a body shot like Yaxley did then, and McCauley just smiled back. He's been hit so many times to the head and body.
Just trying something a bit different here now, Kevin. Just trying to get on the front foot a little bit, see what reaction he can get there. Any way he can stay safe, really, isn't it?
Yeah, and he's one of the best at doing that.
Right up to a body landed again there. He's landed three or four nice body shots, hasn't he?
Yeah, and like we said during the round, that's just what his corner called for, and already that's a positive sign as well. He's listening to his corner. Another round in the bank, and it's been punch perfect so far, really. And you can see he's got plenty of gears that he can go up to. But he seemed just happy to just cruise through this one and show his skills.
Yeah, two rounds safely in the bank there for Sean Yaxley.
I don't think he's been hit yet in there, to be fair.
James Moorcroft, Lee and Luke were away on a sparring trip. Nothing better to do than watch VIP boxing in the hotel room. James has got a fight coming up in early December, hasn't he? Caps off another good year for Mr. Moorcroft.
Yeah, that's the next VIP show, December the 8th at Bolton. That's a cracking show. That's some great fights on there. Certainly worth tuning into that one as well.
Mike Davis and Julie Stephen watching over in America.
Round three.
Say Masha's going to walk his fight tonight. Well, Jordan Ellison can certainly put up a bit of a fight. So as long as Sean doesn't take his eye off the ball, should be okay. But as we say, Ellison's a decent opponent.
You mentioned it before the fight, and usually you see a spell where McCauley really comes and has a go, but we haven't seen that yet so far. Yaxley's done really well just to keep him on the back foot.
Yeah, Kevin mustn't have seen an opening or an opportunity yet to just test out Yaxley, make him in the final round, you know, give it his all.
Nice stab to the body from Yaxley. I think that's an underrated shot against these journeymen. Just stabbing straight down to the body through the guard. Starts to have an effect when he steps up in rounds as well.
Jab's just found its home a couple of times and just turned that jab to his stomach, turned it into a nice left hook there, didn't he?
Yeah, he certainly picks his shots very well.
The amateurs these days are so advanced, aren't they? You know, the level they fight at and the company they're mixing. But even during like the Four Nations tournaments, if you're boxing internationally for Wales, you're mixing with some real top class amateurs. So far advanced, we can make pretty swift progress.
Yeah, I was at the CYS finals nationals last night, and even then, the amateur talent on show there is unbelievable.
Body shot again by Yaxley.
That's just sparked McCauley into life a little bit, that body shot.
Most impressive thing for Yaxley today, I think it's been his accuracy. He's not wasted anything, has he?
No, every time.
Whenever he's seen an opening, he's landed it.
Yeah, you can see he's thinking about when he throws it at the right times. And like you said, he's landed every shot. Nice little uppercut from McCauley, though. Coming towards the end of this third round. Another one comfortably in the bank. Oh, lovely work to the body, right and left. McCauley just acknowledging that as well. Nice left hook to the head.
Kevin just calling him on there after he got a shot. Took a shot. There's a little burst from Kevin. Few more people watching on the stream tonight. Thanks for joining us. Share the link. There's no other boxing tonight, so get it around. We've got Graham Sullivan asking when Sean Cairns is on. Good fight. Sean Cairns is in tonight. We're expecting him in the ring probably between 9:15 and 9:30. Mark Bell saying Masha's a pride of Birkenhead.
Yeah, the Cairns and Fido fight has the potential to be a barnstormer, doesn't it? Brett Fido's found a bit of form recently. You can see he wants a title shot soon, and Cairns will be looking to derail that, but it's not going to be an easy night for Sean Cairns.
No, I've been waiting for years to see a journeyman try and turn it around and really try and get somewhere, and it seems like Brett just had enough of losing.
Yeah, it's similar to Nathan Hardy as well. He's had I think three wins and a draw on the bounce.
Well, 10
a few of these Germans have just decided that they want these title shots, and they're proving how good
second
fighters
out,
they are.
Fourth and final round.
Fido's taken three undefeated records in a row, hasn't he? And also got a draw in there. So Cairns has got to be on his game tonight. Anyway, back to Sean Laxley. Fourth round of his debut.
He's just looking so comfortable in there. Nice work from the jab again.
You know, it's not been fireworks and explosive, but he's been quietly impressive here, Sean Laxley, hasn't he?
Yeah, and in his corner, he'd be very, very happy with the work he's done. Especially boxing away from home, just a nice, quiet, shut-out performance on points. That's exactly what he's done.
Just kept Kevin McCauley fully in his box the entire four rounds. something we often say, isn't it, when we watch these young debutants and guys young in their career, you've got to take all the ambition away from the opponent pretty much straight away.
Yeah, and when these journeymen do get wins, it's because they have success in the opening round or the opening two rounds and feel like they can win the fight. You do what Yaxley's done tonight. McCauley's just looking for the finish line now.
McCauley trying a bit of a rope-a-dope there. Seems to me every time he's tried that, he's taken a pretty heavy body shot though.
Yeah. You mentioned it in the last round, it's that accuracy with every shot that he's throwing. And you can see why he's had such success as an amateur. Good work from McCauley though. Stabbed to the body with the left hand. And there's that little flurry we were talking about.
Let us know on the VIP Facebook stream what you think of Sean Laxley's performance. I'm guessing it's the first time many of you have seen him, unless you're amateur boxing fans. So just let us know what you think. Are you impressed? How far do you think he can go? Any other hopes in Wales? We'll talk about it tonight. Just give us a shout.
Last 30 seconds of this final round of his debut. Really impressive performance so far. The left hook landing. It's a bit of a shame for him that the Christmas break's come now, isn't it? He'd have liked to have been out in a few weeks' time again. He'll have to wait till after Christmas.
I'm sure Kevin's got another couple of bookings planned, though. Pay for that Christmas break and everything quiets down in January, so he'll be desperate to cram them in only before the end of the year. He safely negotiates that one, so.
And he hardly even looked out of breath in that corner there, actually. Easy night's work for him. And I think there's no doubt what the referee's scorecard's going to look like after that one. MC Michael Pass just getting confirmation from the referee on that score. You can hear Kevin McCauley in there saying to Yaxley he's sharp. And that's a big compliment coming from someone like Kevin, who's been in with countless prospects. If he's giving you compliments, you've done something right. Hand over to the MC Michael Paston, we'll get the official result.
Ladies and gentlemen, after four intriguing rounds of boxing action, referee Jamie Kirkpatrick has adjudged this first contest 40 points to 36 points for your winner. On his proud professional debut from Rutland, Sean Yaxley. And the evergreen, young man from Starbridge, appreciation please for Kevin McCauley. 206 contests, not out. Thank you.